Hi there. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a quick and simple poll in Google Forms so that you can easily gather opinions, votes, or valuable feedback from your target audience. So without any ado, let's get started. So step one, open Google Chrome and search for Google Forms, or click on the menu button in the top right corner and then scroll down to find Forms and click on that. And this will take you to the Google Forms dashboard. Next, click on blank form and rename this form to be, let's say, a productivity poll. And here in the untitled question, provide your question. In this case, let's say, what's the biggest productivity killer in your team? After adding your question, in the dropdown, you can change the type of this question. For example, we have multiple choice questions where we can add multiple options and the respondent will be able to select only one of these options. Or we can change this to a checkbox where the respondent can select multiple options. Or if we are trying to gather a rating from the respondent, we can use linear scale question where we can set a scale rating from 0 to 10 or 1 to 5. And we can also use the rating question to do the same. And here we can change the emojis. Now the question type depends on the kind of poll that you're trying to run and the purpose behind the poll. Now, when it comes to poll types, there are 7 common types of polls. You can pause the screen to go through all the different types of polls and their purpose and where they can be used, and also an example question. For example, if you're trying to do market research to understand your target audience better, you can use an opinion poll. And in this case, you can use a multiple choice field and ask a question like, what's your opinion on a particular topic, and provide multiple options and let the users select the options in that poll. And then based on their options, you can understand their pain points or their opinion about a particular topic. So for this tutorial, we'll carry out our opinion poll where we'll use multiple choice question and we'll have 4 different options. So we have 4 different options. We can also add other. With this option, the respondent can basically provide an answer that is not available in any of these questions. We'll also make this required. And if we want to add any creatives into this question or into this particular poll, we can use the image icons to embed an image into this question itself, or we can click on the design icon and then basically upload a header image into this. And we can also change the color of this and the font style and etc. Now for an effective poll, you can ask a maximum of up to 3 questions. If you ask anything more than that, it will essentially become a survey or a complete questionnaire. And if you're trying to collect immediate feedback from your customers or your target audience and make a quick decision, then it is wise to keep it under 3. And make sure the questions are clear and easy to understand and the options are highly relevant to the particular question. Next, let's go ahead and publish this poll. To do that, simply hit on the publish button. And here you will find this option. Click on manage. And make sure the responder view is set to be anyone with the link. If you set this to be restricted, then people will not be able to fill out the details. So let's keep this as anyone with the link. And then hit publish. Now, if you want to make this poll anonymous, meaning you do not want to collect any email address from the respondent, or you do not want the respondent to sign into their Gmail account in order to fill out the poll, you can do that by heading over to settings and you can go to form defaults and change this to be do not collect. And you can also go to the responses and make this do not collect. Now, all we have to do is click on the link icon and copy the responder link. We can shorten the URL as well, and paste it in places where we want people to participate in this particular poll. Now, once you start collecting responses, you can see them in the response tab where we have summary. We can also break down the responses based on individual questions, or we can break it down based on individual responses. Now, for a poll, summary is the best analysis because in this, you will get a pie chart, which will basically show the percentage of people who have answered different options for that particular question. If you want to link this to a Google Sheet, you can also do that with this option, or you can download all the responses as a CSV file. So that's it for this short tutorial. I hope you found this to be valuable. If you want us to explore more topics, kindly share them in the comment section. I will see you in the next one.